Welcome back to First Coast Living, folks. I am joined by a crew of people here with the Jacksonville Armada and the Fire Department and our Jacksonville Sheriff's Office. Randy Wise here from the Fire Department. Officer Rock, or yes, T-Rock.
That's right.
That's how you, I like to, with officers, I know, look, man, Randy, firefighters, obviously, extremely important as well, but with officers, I always want to make sure I'm talking to them correctly.
They got a gun, bro. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, they
she
got a gun.
It's loaded. Yeah. Officer Rock with the JSO.
Yes, very nice to be here.
We got Drew Becky from the Armada and Zach Steinberger from the Armada as well. How you guys doing?
Good. Solid.
Randy, you were at one of the fire departments that the Armada recently came out and visited. Right. Mm-hmm. And for those who don't know, they went around and visited fire departments, police officers all around the city. What was it like to see the guys and the team come out and visit you guys?
You know, anytime you get a special guest coming in like that, it's special to the men and women, you know, especially seeing pro athletes like they are. The men and women really appreciate that. And, you know, just the pure fact of somebody coming in and saying thank you for what you do, and you know, being able to talk to them and actually being in the station. You know, a lot of people, probably most citizens, don't get to come into something like that. And I know they were looking at the fire trucks and they were kind of showing them some of the stuff and kind of how we work.
And right? The pole.
Some of them, actually did. Look at the pole. So no doubt.
That's the best part.
We appreciate them coming out. It was great.
No, it's really cool. They got a chance to go out to a bunch of different of the firehouses and police stations. And Officer Rock, when you know the whole crowd is going to recognize first responders and they'll make announcements and honor certain officers and firefighters, when you're at those games, what does that feel like to be for once, you know, it seems for once everybody cheering for you instead of people screaming at you and stuff?
Yes, absolutely. It's an honor and it's a great privilege to have popular athletes here in Jacksonville taking the time out to let us know they support us. As public servants of the community, we don't look for recognition, but it's great to have that support, and it's refreshing because we do face different challenges and we do make certain sacrifices. So I am very grateful and thankful for you. And
no, we're grateful.
We appreciate you guys taking the time out to just recognize us. As far as being one of our core values, Sheriff Mike Williams always tells us, is being community focused. And so this allows us to build that bridge with the Armada soccer team. So it's a great feeling.
Very cool. And guys, what was it like going out there and getting to see these folks in their offices?
Yeah, it's special for one because we take for granted what they do every single day. They go out knowing that you know, it's a dangerous job, and we know if anything happens, they're going to be there. So it's important for us to remember that. And I mean, we get to play a game for a living, so we have to make sure that we remember that every day.
Yeah. No, I've been lucky enough to visit a couple different sheriff's offices and fire departments in my day, and you know, the first one I did, I was actually in Houston, and I visited a fire department office, and they had me do the two-minute drill where you have to put on your everything in 2 minutes, and just after doing that, I mean, that was one of the most impressive things I've ever seen anyone do. They had one of the rookies do it in under 2 minutes, and then I tried to do it, and I think it maybe took me like 20 minutes, and then I got it on, and I was sweating so much I wanted to just pass out. It's seriously so impressive what these guys do every day. To have one night devoted to them is something that we're super grateful to do, super happy to do, and we're really looking forward to Saturday night. And even more so, the good old tug of war competition we're gonna have at halftime.
That's right.
So I'm gonna be listening for the cheers in the locker room, seeing who's taking home the championship.
That's right. There's a tug of war at halftime between the fire department and the police. The police. So who's gonna win?
We got some pretty big folks coming, so I don't.
If Randy's in there, I know where my money's going.
I'm sure I'm too old to be doing that. I will not be out there pulling out.
I know.
You know, we always worry about that. We always got to worry about them having with the gun.
Yeah.
So. Well, I will tell you that there's a relationship between the police and fire here in Jacksonville that's fantastic. Yes. We have to do lots of charity stuff together. We're out there in the streets together, protecting the citizens every day. We rely on them; they rely on us.
Yes.
So it's a great way to come together and show our camaraderie and really, you know, that we're out there to help the citizens. And again, we appreciate y'all recognizing us and what we do.
Of course.
Appreciate it. Mm-hmm. All right, we're out of time, guys. Appreciate you guys being here. Remember, want to show support for them as well as the Armada? Come on out to Hodges Stadium. We got a whole bunch more coming up on First Coast Living. Stick around. We'll be back.